In this tutorial, we'll bring text to life inside After Effects, creating a dynamic animation where layers detect and react to one another. The process will be broken down into three main parts. First, we'll create expressions with an AI, and it's important to note that the point isn't to study the code in detail, but simply to generate and use it. Next, we'll handle the physics animation with Newton, and finally, we'll finalize the design with Connect Layers Pro. Let's start with the heart of the project. Creating the expressions. We'll have the AI do the work here. It'll write and debug the code, so our job is just to guide it with the right prompts. We'll develop three different ones. The first will detect and display the number of text layers within a defined and adjustable perimeter. The second will vary the scale based on that number, and the third will change the stroke width using the same principle. For this, I'm going to use ChatGPT, but any generative AI will do. I'll start by giving it the context with a simple prompt. I want an expression for Adobe After Effects. Then, I'll send my specific request. I want to put an expression on a text layer that counts the number of layers around it, within a perimeter of 300 pixels. The AI gives me a first version. I copy it, then in After Effects, I create a new text layer and apply the expression to its source text property. I duplicate the layer, and it doesn't work anymore. So, I describe the problem to the AI so it can correct the code. Let's try this new expression. I duplicate it, and this time, it works. Let's continue. To test that the expression ignores other layer types, I'm creating a solid. I ask for a new expression. I want to detect only the text layers in my comp. I copy and paste it. And there's an error. I take a screenshot and send it to the AI. Let's see what it suggests. And it's still not working. I send it the new error. And here is its new version. We copy, we paste. Ah, this seems to be working. So I copy the expression to the other layers. But the problem is, if a layer moves, it no longer detects the others. All right, one more new version. I copy and paste it. Ah, this time it seems to be working properly. Let's move on to animating the scale property. First, I want the scale of the layers to change based on the number of neighbors detected. At 0 layers, 25% of its size, and at 9 layers, 150%. I also want to limit the displayed number to 9. I apply the expression to the scale parameter. Looks like this is working great. I duplicate the layer, and the result is what I expected. Now, I'm also going to use the expression that will limit the displayed number to 9. I apply it, duplicate all these layers, and indeed it works. Even with lots of layers around, the number stays capped at 9. I only keep one layer for my last expression. Finally, I want the typography's stroke width to vary as well. 0 layers detected, no stroke. 9 or more layers, a stroke width of 10. I add a stroke parameter to my text layer. And paste the new expression into it. I duplicate the layers, and we can clearly see the stroke width evolving. And just like that, our expressions are complete. We've built a powerful procedural system where our layers are now intelligent, able to see their neighbors and change their appearance automatically. With this setup complete, we have the foundation we need for the next step. Now we can move on to Newton for the physics simulation. I'll keep just one layer, center its anchor point, and apply a circular mask to it. set its transfer mode to none. Important note, we're temporarily deactivating the scale expression so our objects aren't too big for the simulation. We'll reapply it later. Then I duplicate my layer about 20 times. I launch Newton. I select my objects and use the randomizer to scatter my objects across the entire composition. A few layers are a bit outside, so I adjust their position. I turn off gravity and activate comp walls. I apply a magnetic repulsion force to all objects. And I adjust the intensity and distance. For a more lively motion, I use the randomizer on the magnetism properties. For the distance, I'll set a range between 150 and 300, and for the intensity, I'll use values between 400 and 800. My objects aren't moving at first, so I'm going to give them a random initial velocity and direction to get them all moving. I'll also set the bounciness to 1 so that energy is always conserved. And I'll especially apply this to the walls so that even the walls constantly return the same amount of energy. And I can hit render. So, what does it look like in After Effects? I have my new composition, I open it. It's good, but the problem is my objects are constantly rotating. So I'll delete this composition, go back to Newton, select all my objects, go to the advanced properties, and click fix rotation. I render again. And now, well, it gives me the right animation. Now for the finishing touches, I notice that my layers detect a maximum of 5 neighbors at any time. So I'm going to modify the stroke expression to say that the maximum value of 10 is reached as soon as 5 layers are detected. I copy paste this modified expression to all my layers. Then I also need to reapply the scale expression to all of my layers. And there we go. The animation with Newton and all the interactive layers is now ready. Let's move on to Connect Layers Pro. I create a null object and place it in the center of the composition. Then I launch the script. Select all my text layers in order. And finally my null object. Then I click on many to one. And there you go. Connect Layers Pro has created a shape layer that is controllable with an effect. I can now adjust its appearance. I change the curviness to quadratic in-out, for example, modify the stroke width to get something finer, and activate the trim to have it start at 10%. To finish, I'm going to apply a gradient to the lines. I open the shape layer created by Connect Layers Pro. I take the first path, find the gradient, and edit it. Afterwards, I select it, copy it, then select all the other colors and paste. And there, the gradient is applied everywhere. And that's it, the animation is finished. And there you have it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and most importantly, that it showed you the power of combining different tools. We started from a simple idea to build complex expressions with an AI. We brought our objects to life with Newton's physics. And we fine-tuned the final design with Connect Layers Pro. Don't be afraid of this trial and error process. As we saw, it's an integral part of creation. So now it's your turn to experiment.